So in this video, we are going to convert these boring tooltips into these amazing tooltips. Now, what are tooltips? There is a chart. You hover on top of it. It shows you the default data. So using Power BI, you can enhance two things. One is what is shown in the tooltip. That's easy. But even more revolutionary is you look at the tooltip as though it was a report page, and you can build a report inside a tooltip. And that's an outstanding feature, because just with mouse cursor movement, you are showing so much useful information. We need some sample data. And the simplest thing is to use the sample data from here. We'll say load sample data. There's only one table there. We'll pick it up and then we will create some visuals. We have lots of columns here, and using this, we are going to create visuals. So let's create a simple visual first. I'm going to expand the field list and I'm going to create a simple chart. Stack column chart. I'm going to close the filter area so that we can see it clearly. And I'm going to drag and drop the sales, which goes onto the y-axis, that will be plotted. And I'm going to drag and drop segment as x-axis. So simple chart. Now, what is tooltip? Tooltip, everyone knows, when I hover the cursor, it's going to show me the default tooltip. Now remember, I'm using the latest version of Power BI. Go to File, Options and Settings. Again, go to Options, and under Preview Features, make sure you have enabled Modern Visual Tooltips. If you activate it now and click OK, it may ask you to restart Power BI. If you are using an older version of report, which was already created, you still have to go to Report Settings, and there also you have to enable the Modern Visual Tooltips. So having done this, now we have Modern Tooltips. In order to add something more to the tooltip so that it becomes richer, what do? You click on the visual on this side under the data part of the visualization. You can see what is in x-axis, what is in y-axis. But if you scroll down, it is saying, do you want to add something else to the tooltips as well? For example, I'm going to add the sales price. Now what happens? When I go here, it's going to show me three things instead of two things. So this is how you can customize the content of the tooltip. That's number one. When I add product here, it's going to show me both segment and product. And why does that happen? Because it is currently doing that drill down. So I'm going to drill up and stay at the segment level. These arrows are called the drill down arrows, and they are very confusing. But notice what happens now. When I hover on one of these, you will see a drill down button here. This is called the modern tooltip. I'm going to enable data labels so we know what we are looking at. So now government is 53 million. When I click on the drill down, what is it going to do? It is going to take government as the filter and break it down by products which are under government. So now if I go here and say drill down, the total of all these will be 52 million. Now, how do I go up? Oh, that also can happen from the tooltip, because now it knows we have gone one level down. Now that button becomes drill up. Now, just to make it a little more complicated, I'm going to add month as well. So now I have three levels. Now it's going to show me the lowest level by default, which is not what I want. So what will I do? I'll just go to the highest level from here. Now, notice drill down will come, and this will drill it to product. And now below product, we have month name. So now we will have two options. Do you want to go upwards to segment or downwards to month name? So this is how a tooltip itself allows you to investigate further. There's no need to right click, no need to struggle with these confusing arrows. It's happening right there within the tooltip. So this is how the base tooltip itself can be enriched. But that's just one way. The idea is, whatever is happening in the current tooltip, it's just some text and number, that's it. I want that tooltip itself to have some visuals there. And those visuals should get filtered by wherever I hovered the mouse cursor. And that is done by creating a separate page which will act like the tooltip. For that, I'm going to add a new page. And we will just double click on it, and I will call it TT for tooltip. In real life, we don't want this page to be visible when people are looking at the report, so you just right click and hide it. Right now it is visible, but when you publish the report, that page will be hidden. Every page has properties. When nothing is selected, format your report page. Okay, and we have page information, which basically gives you the name, and here you can say I want this entire page to behave like a tooltip, so allow use as tooltip. Now you will notice that the size suddenly reduced, because it's a tooltip. If it is too big, then it's going to overlap the rest of the report, so it becomes confusing. So there is a size for tooltip. Where do you control that size? Well, you have canvas settings. And because I marked this page as a tooltip, it changed its size. If you want to, you can always make it a bigger size page as well. But I would not recommend that, because the tooltip cannot be too big. It's very confusing. So let's leave it at tooltip size. Okay, so far so good. Now, just to show how this works, I'm going to put some text on top of it. So let's go to visuals and let's put a simple card. And I'm going to put sales. So what is it going to show me? The total sales. That's all there is to it right now. What I want is this should be shown as a tooltip for visuals on other pages. Now the question is, which visuals should show this tooltip? So let's go back to our original chart and see what happened. Nothing has changed here, right? Now remember, this particular visual has segment, product, month name, and sum of sales. Okay, the segment. Just remember segment right now. Now what do I need to do? I am in this page, which is a tooltip page. And now what is it saying? Drag tooltip fields here. What does that mean? So I'm going to drag segment here. What basically it means is any visual somewhere else on other pages which has segment field in it will invoke this as the tooltip. So let's see that in action. So actually this visual, nothing has changed. But now if I hover here, it's actually showing me this custom tooltip. Right now it's just simple and it's exactly showing whatever is there. But that's okay. This is how custom page can become a tooltip. So far so good. Now I'm going to create a slightly more refined tooltip by adding something, not just a number. Let's add a chart there. So I'm going to now put country and let's put the sales. So what is going to happen now? It's going to show me a bubble chart, a map of countries. Now let's come back here and see what happens. Now for each of these, you'll see countries, and as I hover on different bars, I am seeing the change in the contribution by each country, and that is how enriched tooltips can be created. Now let's do one more thing. I'm going to duplicate this page. This is a tooltip page. So when I duplicate it, this also is a tooltip page. So I'm just going to call it TT2. Now the only thing I'm going to change here is actually the visual. So instead of this visual, I'm going to do something else. So in this case, let's put year. In the x-axis, and let's put sales in y-axis. Here also, for this tooltip page, we are saying any visual which has segment in it should show this tooltip. And here also, in the other tooltip page, we have said same thing. So any visual which has segment in it should show this tooltip also. Now there is a confusion, because there are two potentially applicable tooltip pages. So now what happens? I'm going to this visual, which does have segment in it. Now it has to show a tooltip, but there are two pages. Now what will it show? It cannot show two tooltips at the same time. So what is it going to do? It's going to pick up the first one which came in the list of tooltips. Now this is not what you want. Maybe you want the other tooltip to be shown here. Now so far what is happening? Any visual which has segment in it, it's going to show up this tooltip. Now I want to control that. For this particular visual, I want the other tooltip to be shown. How do I do that? So this is a setting for this particular visual. So let's go to format your visual. Then we go to general, and here we have tooltips. There are tooltips on. Of course, you can shut them off, in which case there will be no tooltip at all. But of course, we want the tooltip, and then that map will come. But now open this, and here we have some options important to understand. By default, what is happening? Report page. And which page? Auto. Oh, so let's understand this drop down first. If I open this, there is something called default. And now what happens? The good old standard tooltip is coming. The other option is report page, which we just saw. And which report page? That is being decided automatically. That's why it's coming in the first come, first serve order. But now I want to explicitly say I want the second tooltip page to be considered here. And now you can see that tooltip page is now specifically for this particular visual. Now, just to show the difference, I'm going to create one more visual. And this time, just for variation, I'm going to create a pie chart. And in this pie chart, we will put segment and sales. So now I have this visual, which is showing me the tooltip 2 page. And in this case, because I have not specifically said anything, but it does have segment, it is going to show me the first page. So that is how report page can be converted into a tooltip. And what is the real benefit of all this? Just by hovering the cursor, you're in a position to understand details. Now, in both these pages, we have just one visual. That's not required. You could have split this into two parts. This is the area available, and I could have put something else as well. So this is how you should enrich your reports by expecting what will people want to see when they hover on a particular visual, and accordingly you create the tooltip pages, and then the same report with less effort, people are understanding better. Now, there is one important thing to remember. This is our visual, which is showing our tooltip. Now, when I filter it on something, for example, October in this case, there is one overall portion and there is a highlighted portion. So it's only going to show you that part. It is not going to show you a different tooltip for the overall portion and the highlighted portion. Also, another constraint or disadvantage of this report page tooltip is the drill down and drill through options, which are available in the standard tooltip, are not going to be available here. So you have to pick and choose depending on the circumstances. So that's it for now. I hope you like it, and then share it with other people as well and start using it. If you have any queries, put it in comments, subscribe, click the bell icon, and explore the Super Thanks option as well. That's it for now. Thank you.